Hello everyone, my name is Li Hao. So today we are going to try Advent of Code 2020. So Advent of Code 2020 is a series of mini puzzles in the Advent calendar. So every day you have one mini puzzles, that two mini puzzles actually, to solve, and solving that will give you stars. And actually Advent of Code has been for a few years, but this is my first time trying it, so let's take a look how we're gonna solve this Advent of Code. So over here, we're gonna go for the first puzzle. So I've logged in to my account and let's go. Right, so day one, report repair. Well, after saving Christmas 5 years in a row, I think this has been, Advent of Code has been for 5 years. You've decided to take a vacation at a nice resort on a tropical island. Surely, Christmas will go on without you. While the tropical island has its own currency and it's entirely cash only, the gold coins used there have a little picture of a starfish. And locals just call them stars. None of the currency exchanges seems to have heard of them, but somehow you'll need to find 50 of those coins by the time you arrive so you can pay the deposit on your room. To save your vacation, you need to get all 50 stars by December 25th. Right, so every day, there will be two puzzles be made available on each day, the Advent calendar. And the second puzzle is unlocked when you complete the first. Each puzzle grants one star. Good luck. So before you leave, the elves in accounting just need you to fix your expenses report. Apparently something isn't quite adding up. Specifically, they need you to find two entries that sums up to 2020 and then multiply those two numbers together. For example, in this list of numbers, sum to 2020 are 7021 and 299, right? So multiplying these two numbers gives us 514,579. And so this is the answer that we need to submit, right? Of course, the expense report is much larger. So these links will give me the puzzle input, where it will give us, I hope it will give us a list of numbers, right? So this is the list of numbers. We're gonna find two of the numbers that adds up to 2020. Once we find them, we're gonna get the product of the multiplication of that two number. Right, so the first thing is, I'm gonna save this. Put text. Right, and over here I've set up my project. So I have the Advent of Code folder. I'm gonna copy the file into this folder, and I'm gonna create a file. And I'm gonna code in this file. Right. So I'm gonna use JavaScript. JavaScript is my favorite programming language. I love JavaScript. So I'm gonna run JavaScript in command line, right? So that will be using Node.js. So first thing is I'm gonna read the file. And I'm gonna read using file system. So I'm gonna pass in the file name. The name is this. And I'm going to pass in the encoding of the file, which is UTF-8. So I got the content. Right. So in this file, numbers are one number per line, right? So so if you don't see it, there is an invisible new line character in between every character, in between the lines. And that, when you open up in the editor, that represents as a new line. Right, so we're gonna split this string by the new line character. Oops. And so this gives us an array of strings, right? So each line is one string, and actually they are numbers, right? So we're gonna convert the number, the string to number. So gonna map it, right? So this will give us the array. So now we're going to find two numbers within this array that adds up to 2020. So one quick way to do this is that we're going to loop through the array, and we are going to find, so for each number, we're going to find 2020 minus that number. So we get another number that we are going to find, and then we see this number whether is it existed in the array itself, right? So if it's in the array, meaning both the pair exist, so that would be what we are looking for, and we're going to calculate the product of the multiplication of these two numbers. I'm going to print that out. Right, so one quick way to find whether a number exists within an array is to actually use a set, right? So I'm going to create a new set out of the array, and then I'm going to loop through the array. Item of array, I think call it number better, right? It means more meaningful. So number, and so the, I'm going to call it the other number, goes to 2020 minus the number, right? So we're going to find whether is this number has existed in the set. If it does, meaning both the number and the other number existed in this array, and that means that we find our pair that adds up to 2020. So if set has, then we're going to console out the number times the other number. We're going to get the product, and we're going to break. We're going to not continue the loop anymore, right? So let's run this. 444019. Okay, let's try this. Submit. Yay! That's the right answer. You got the first gold star closing to save your vacation. Let's continue to part two, shall we? Well, the elves in accounting are thankful for your help. One of them even offers you a starfish coin they have left over from a past vacation. They offer you a second one if you can find three numbers in your expense report that match the same criteria. Using the above example again, so we're going to use the same input. Three entries that sums to 2020 is this three number. So multiplying them gets a new product, right? So we're going to find three numbers that adds up to 2020 instead of two. So let's see how we can do this. So we can't use this trick anymore because we need three numbers, right? We need the other number and the third number. Let's take a look at the input. How big is this file? Well, it's 200 numbers, right? So it's not that big. So I'm thinking of using brute force to solve this problem, right? So brute force in this case is that we're going to find combinations of three numbers, and we're going to find all the combinations of three numbers. So we try every combination, like the first number, second number, third number, first, second, fourth, first, second, fifth, first, second, sixth. We try all the combinations and add them up. So if any of the combination meets the criteria that adds up to 2020, we're going to get the product of it and we're going to print that out, right? So it's brute force in the sense where we are trying all the combinations. And we can do this is because the input is small, right? The part one when we are doing it, we are doing it a bit efficient, kind of, where we use a set data structure for us to have a fast retrieval to find a number. In this case, we can cheat a bit where it's still possible to use some data structure to find three numbers that adds up to 2020. But I think that with the current input, the fastest way for us to implement it is to go brute force, right? And then we figure out, if it's too slow, we figure out something, a better data structure. So I'm going to clear this. I'm going to write our loop. So we're going to have I starting from array 0 to array.length. I'm gonna have J and K. Right, so I'm cheating a bit. I am duplicating this code, right? So I'm using VS Code. So if you want to duplicate the same code, you use alternate option, shift and down key or up key, arrow key, right? That will duplicate these multiple lines. So I'm gonna loop through ijk. So ijk, j will start from I plus one because I don't need. I don't think I'm supposed to use the same number twice, right? Same case with k should be j plus one. And actually, I doesn't have to iterate all the way to the length of the array, because after it reaches like minus one, we don't really have like two more numbers behind it, right? So this will be minus two and this is gonna be minus one, right? Beyond that, you can't find any tree combinations that is after I plus one. So we have ijk. What we're gonna do next is gonna calculate sum. Sum equals to array, whoops, I, j, k. And if the sum is 2020, we're gonna find the product, right? So the product would be actually replace the plus with multiplication, and we're gonna break. Right? But if we break here, it will only break the nearest for loop, which is not what we want. We want to break everything. So what we can do here is can add a label to the outermost for loop, and we can break based on the label, right? So this will break all the way to the outermost for loop. Let's run this code. Zero. Wait. Is there something wrong about this? Okay, probably one of the numbers is 0 and it adds up to 2020, right? As long as it console out something, it should be the answer. Let's try it out. 0. That's not the right answer. That's bad. Let's try it. Okay, let's take a look at what is the... what are the three values that so-called adds up to 2020, right? 251, 1769. Okay, indeed adds up to 0. And let's see, ijk. What's the value of ijk? Okay, so the last number is, oh wait, I think I know why, because there's an extra new line character here. So I think it converts to 0, which is not part of the input, right? Let me remove this and let's try to run again. Yeah, I think this number seems more reasonable. Let's try it out. Yay! So that's the right answer. So we got 2 stars now. We have completed day 1 of Advent of Code. And I'm going to try day 2. So that will be on the next video. So please remember to subscribe to my channel if you want to watch the next video when it's out. Right? So see ya!